Hi students, today we are going to discuss a case study on the topic digital security. It is one of the applications, it is one of the practical application of the subject digital electronics that we are learning. So we are living in an era of computers, we are living in the era of internet. So we process large amount of data and we process large amount of information. Security has been a major concern nowadays. We need to provide security to all the resources files that we have, and also we need to ensure that these security measures happen at a minimal cost also. So this has been a real challenge for us. So here comes the practical application of our subject digital electronics. So as we know, we have been familiar with all the traditional security measures that we have been using in day-to-day life. So as time drastically changes, we have moved to the digital era. So why digital security has become much popular when compared to that of traditional security? So first thing, that it provides optimum security at minimum cost. That is the main advantage of that. It provides optimum security at minimum cost. So what is optimum security? We should ensure that our resources and data has been protected to the maximum of its limit, and we are not interested, nobody will be interested in taking there will be any mismatch or compromise in the security concepts. So we will ensure maximum security without compromising that, but also we need to ensure the cost of that security system that we are going to use has to be minimal at the level. So in order to ensure minimum security, we apt a system called as digital security systems. So in our day-to-day life, we come across many digital security devices, systems such as mainly surveillance cameras. When we speak of computers, there are many security access, many kinds of license keys are there that provides securities, even those against computer viruses, those kinds of protective measures, that antivirus softwares, servers, smart cards, firewalls, all these stuff has been used in, this comes under digital security also. But I'm going to speak about some practical application of the digital security, the practical measures that has been taken for that. The surveillance cameras is also a digital security measure that we use to ensure the safety of the of our compound walls, compounds of our area, or our resources, etc. Similarly, we have many security measures, and today we will exclusively talk on one of the security measure that we use, digital door lock. We might have been using the traditional door locking systems in our homes. We are familiar with that. So there are many practical limitations of that. Whenever robbery could easily happen, because they can easily break the door, and the robbery could have been easily happen. Hence, we go for a digital door lock system. So a digital door lock system is very easy to install when compared to that of a conventional lock and key systems. So they provide high security when compared to that of an easy breakable metal lock systems. So conventionally we might be using metal lock system, metal lock door. When compared to that, digital door lock provides much security when compared to that. So another advantage of that, with the increase of the unrest, they need to have better safety. They can provide better safety on digital lock entries, and it's a perfect guardian that protects your locker, home, and other areas of choice. So it could be a better option when compared to that of other traditional techniques. So with more and more sophisticated locking technologies on the rise, the market of this digital door lock has increased conventionally. The technology of the lock, there may be a doubt whether it is purely digital or electrical. It is a combo of both. It is a combo of both digital as well as electrical. There is no clear winner between these two technologies. So it's electrical lock is a good for minor storage boxes, house, rooms, etc. But when we compare of locker facilities or a better home automation techniques, we will be opting digital lock techniques. And why we are opting digital lock techniques is we can introduce a fingerprint option in that only the homeowner can use the fingerprint option. We can sense the fingerprint in that and open the door. We can even put codes on that. We can type certain codes. We can set certain patterns, as we have seen in mobile phone locking systems and all. We can use certain patterns for that to open the door. Obviously, the next important factor would be the strength of the lock. How strong it is to overcome any or withstand any kind of sort or any drilling equipment, etc. So it depends upon the cost at which we buy the material. The material speaks the cost of that. How strong our digital lock facility is. So it depends upon the material that we use. Similarly, unlocking mechanisms. This again purely it is an experienced tip. Digital locks majorly have password, pattern, biometric, or a combination of all these. So based on the security level, these applications will vary. Okay, so that's what the difference between electrical as well as digital lock. So as I told already, it is a combo of both electrical as well as digital lock facility. So this could provide optimum or maximum security to the kind of security that we require for our home or our locker facilities or our office or whatever may be. So as I told, we can go for fingerprint, we can go for RFID tags, we can go for a mechanical lock or a password protected. It comes in a variety of categories, and based on our requirements, the cost of these materials will vary. This is a typical application of digital electronics in security systems. It is in security. Similarly, we can use digital lock facility in our car doors also. When I speak of a home door locking facility, we can also think of a car door locking facilities. A car door, if we come across BMW or some of the major high costly brands, they are providing a car lock facilities with the help of a digital lock facility. The same techniques that has been used for locking the doors has been incorporated in these kinds of cars to operate it, because only if we apply the pattern or if you apply the pin or if a face recognition will be there or if a fingerprint recognition will be there, based on that the car doors will be opened as well as closed in order to prevent theft and all. So this is one of the practical applications of digital electronics. Thank you, students.